Hello everybody and welcome back to Windbound. This time we're playing through the third chapter, hopefully making some upgrades to our gear and our stuff, and also hopefully not dying, because that would mean starting the game all over again. Now, I have to be very, very careful around animals because they are dangerous and we also have to farm a lot. I'm going to cut some parts out, but if something interesting happens or I die in some funny or ridiculous way, I'm going to leave it in. Now, let's get going. Alright, we've got an island right over there. Let's get to that. Made it to the island, and right off the bat, we've got... Where is it? It was right here. Yeah, we've got a big horner thingy. Big horner. Actually, that's... Fallout New Vegas, isn't it? We've got two of them. Oh, crap. So, how am I doing on arrows? I have 3 metal tips and 10 bone arrows. I've got to keep them separated if I want to actually, yeah, deal with them. That's going to be really hard. Oh, crap. Yeah, this is not going well already. I'm dying. So, after that last death, I actually played through the first and the second chapter again. Had some blessings and upgrades. I kind of upgraded my boat, made a few tools that I needed, and now we're back at the third chapter, but this time I'm playing through storyteller mode. I just don't want to stress myself that much about it. Maybe, perhaps, in a future stream I will play through the survivalist mode until I actually finish the game. Start to finish in survival mode. Now, let's get going and grinding and farming and hopefully finishing that game. Alright, so right off the bat we have to deal with this whatever it's called thingy. I will try to be sneaky about it. But on the way there, let's pick up some supplies. Much better this time. Yeah, the battle system gets a lot easier on storyteller mode. Right, so we've got some meat and a Gorehorn crest. But the item we actually need is a Gloomharrow jaw, so we can make an axe, so we can chop down the little trees. Right, so before we go on with the gathering supplies, let's get some cooking done. Oh, I need some thick grass to reignite the fire. There we go, the fire is ready, let's get some cooking done. And while these things roast, let's get to gathering supplies. And also hunting. Yeah. Yeah, we need the bones so we can make by the spears and arrows. And sticks. Gather as many sticks as you can. If I can give you one advice for this game, is to gather as many sticks as you can. So I have an observation to make. The islands that you find around the sea are, you know, categorized in biomes. For example, this one has a few pigs, a few blinks, the little bunny thingies, gorgons, and then from other supplies, grass, sticks, rocks, and palm fronds. There are other biomes that have bamboo and other monsters and all that stuff. So, yeah, the only advice I can give for that is explore all the islands in between acts, in between chapters. Now let's grab some money from the money rock. Thank you very much. There we go, the meat is cooked. Let's grab that. But we're also out of space, so let's get to more crafting. There we go. So, more meat is cooking, ate something for the road. Now we're ready to leave this island and go to the next one. Let's do just that. Also, yeah, in the last episode, I hadn't built a central deck for, or rather a central hull for the boat, and yeah, the boat was flying all over the place. That was a really bad idea. But now I made one and it's much, much more stable. So, off we go to the next island, which is going to be right over there, straight ahead. And I'll tell you another thing, the boat fire is amazing for doing stuff while you're traveling in between islands. It saves you up much, much time. Build one as soon as possible. Yeah, another thing you should know, sometimes crabs, oh my god, crabs get on your vessel and bad things happen. Like these things that just happened. We lost a bunch of stuff right here. Well, doesn't matter, I'm going to rebuild. Let's get back some bamboo from over there. A bout of bad luck later and we're back on track. And don't worry about the boat, we can rebuild. There. The island is just around this corner. And also it's a key shrine, that's actually good. Yeah, let's park the boat here and explore starting here. Alright, let's see what piece of story we're going to get this time. What once was sacred is now prey. Allies become enemies forevermore. Yeah, your people did some bad things, didn't they, Kara? Right, we got the kit piece, so let's get exploring this island for supplies. Oh! We found a silk moth that we... No, we found a bunch of silk moths. Three, to be specific. That died in one hit it. I love these monsters that die in one hit. And what do we have here? Silk thread. Ooh, can we now build... Excuse me. Thank you. We can now build new items. Specifically, we can build an 18-slot inventory bag that's actually amazing, but I don't have any leather. I lost it all. No, I have some in the basket I have on my deck. Yeah, that's actually nice. We can build a helmet, which reduces fall damage, but we need some planeswalker horns. I think I lost those. And a glider. Yeah, it's, I think, like the glider in, what do you call it? Breath of the Wild, yeah. Also, we can build a couple of bows, a stick bow, and a planeswalker bow, that's... also good, but I already have an unbreakable bow, so yeah, not that useful. And nothing about the boat. I think I found a weird technical bug with this game. Sometimes you can hear the battle music playing and you can actually hear the monsters around you screaming and making noises or whatever, but they glitch inside the trees or the ground and there's pretty much nothing you can do about it. Alright, I won't be sad about it very much. Right, back to the boat, let's see if we can remake the hulls? I can make one hull. Yeah. Tell you what, I'll make a bamboo hull and a grass hull, so at least it will be stable. There we go, it looks a little bit uneven and yeah, the middle hull looks a little bit broken, but it will do for now. But most importantly, now we can build a heavy duty bag. Yeah, this is actually the best piece of equipment we can make for now. But we can't pick up our old bag, it just stays there, I think. Yeah, we can just equip it. Oh well, never mind. That's not that much of a problem. Now let's get going to the next island, hopefully without breaking anything on the way there. Right, the things I can see in the horizon is that island over there, which yeah, we have visited already. And things over on this side. Yeah, let's go this side. Well, I found another island over here, so yeah, let's change our course and go here. And hopefully find a gloom harrow so we can build, an axe. Oh, battle sounds. That's not good. It's not a good time for a fight now. I don't like this. Well, nothing seems to be happening, so I guess we're safe. Well, the battle music stopped, so yeah, we're safe. There we go, I've beached it. Right, so let's get a fire going. And also let's upgrade it. Right, and now we've got that ready. Let's get exploring. And picking up supplies, of course. I don't see a key shrine around, so I'm guessing this is just a supply island. Which is good, we need that, of course. I see lots of bamboo, that's really, really useful. There we go, four bamboo patches all clustered together. That's actually really nice. Right, so I found the key shrine. It's right over there. It was just behind all those trees that clouded my sight. Well, that sounded a little bit heavy as an expression, but you get what I mean. And we found a plane stalker that's sleeping up on that rock. Let it sleep, I say. Don't bother it. Ooh, and bones lying around. Oh, fuck. Well, I guess now we know where those bones came from. Right, so we have good perception of the island up on this rock. I see some animals, but nothing else of interest. Top of the shrine, give me the key piece, and most importantly, give me the cryptic message. Blood oozes from the cracks in the cell. The course has changed. Okay. Has changed to where? Alright, let's do some hunting as well. So we can have some food at the ready. Oh, my spear broke. Let's fix that right away. There we go, brand new spear. Let's get to more hunting then. Did some hunting, collected some meat, some bones. And now we're ready to get cooking and get the freak out of here. Also, let's make some leather. And while we're at it, let's make some bone arrows. Yeah, I have enough feathers, enough bones, and quite a few sticks. So I'm going to use 3 sticks to make a total of 12 basic arrows. And I'm going to upgrade all of these to bone tip arrows. There we go, we're now better prepared for whatever lies ahead. We're back on the boat, back at sea, and we're ready to go to our next destination. Over there in the distance we can see the causeway where we deliver the key pieces and we go through the dungeon and learn more about the story, but I think I should be exploring... Yeah. North a ways this time. I think I see something over this way, so let's get there. And hopefully, on the way there, we will not meet any more sea-based dangers that we actually didn't meet last time. We just heard the battle music. There it is, there's something over that way. Let's get there. We've reached the shore. Let's relight our fire. There we go. And I can't help but notice that there is something strange with that rock straight ahead. I'll go there and explore that. I think there's something going on with that. Hit them with a spear. Beat them with a brick. Crack their shells so thick. One by one they fall. Up to the shores they crawl. Prepare to break them all. I'm running out of stamina, though. Right, so there is something here, but... yeah, these look like giant spears thrown from ballistae or cannons, but I don't think that the technology of Kara's people have reached cannons yet. Right. Perhaps it's a weird secret? I guess we'll find out later. Alright, let's get to exploring the island. And right off the bat, we've got a destroyed village. Let's get to pot breaking. Just a bunch of money so far. Around my neck hangs a boar tusk, carved in a spiral and lined with sacred ink. Through it, the great hunters guide my hand as I stalk proud something that I didn't have the time to read. Storm's Eye Gem. This gem crackles with tiny arcs of lightning. And we've got a Tempest Bow, I'm guessing. A bow that does, you know, electric damage. Yeah, it's exactly that. Lightning damage. And we've got a bonus bone-tipped spear. That's great. And Money Obelisk, yeah. Some broken brazers here. Yeah, this was an altar actually. And what's that over there? Is that a beehive? Is it wise to shoot this? Well, no, actually. As far as I can tell, these silk moth thingies just give us silk threads. Nothing more. No meat, no nothing. And those are sea lilies. What do those do? Magical ingredients. Food bag. Does this help with food not degrading? That's actually nice, but only one bag equipped. Ooh, that's not good. Well, it is good, but yeah, I think the generic item bag is much more useful. For now, for the time being, we have enough food to get us going. And more seal. Oh no, it's not seal, it's a flutter cap? No, this is a flutter cap. A magical ingredient. Don't we get a new recipe for that? Doesn't look like it. Oh, and more silk moss. Prepare to die. I think I can kill this with my knife. I shouldn't be wasting my spear for this. Made it to the shrine. Let's get the key while we're here. And I think this will be the third one, so we're pretty much ready to end this chapter. But honestly, I'm not going to do that. I want to explore a bit more to upgrade our stuff and whatever. There we go. spirits of the underworld emerge to haunt us. What are we fighting for? I'm guessing you did something really, really bad. So the spirits of the underworld and the gods of the sea are... yeah, pissed off that, yeah. Not much else going on this island, just some mushrooms, some blinks, a lot of sea lilies, some silk moss. Yeah, I think we're ready to leave this one. I am going to explore a little bit more and... yeah, if I find something interesting, I'm going to show you. Well, we did find something interesting. We found a gloom harrow. Yes, I need that, but it looks creepy and dangerous. I don't like that. Let's hit it with arrows. If we can. Gloom harrow, could you come back, please? I just want to kill you. Don't be afraid. No, don't go all the way over there. Can I snipe you from here? Yeah, I can. Where are you now? There you go. Let's try and be smart about this. Don't run away. It's almost dead. Not now, Silk Moss. It actually hit me. I think I didn't deal with the Silk Moss, just one left. Now I've dealt with them. Oh, and we actually got a piece of meat from a silk mo, that's new. And again, now back to the gloom harrow. Oh, it's coming right for us, I think. There you go, sniped it all the way to heaven. Give me the thing I need. Yeah, you did. Thank you for that. Right, and this helps us camouflage ourselves. We've got shrouded armor, shrouded hood, and stealth bag. Alright. Let's see what are these things about. 12 extra slots makes us harder to see and hear. That's actually pretty good. And a shrouded hood, yeah, a stealth hood, and a stealth armor. But more importantly, we can build an axe. Let's do this right away. Already, now let's find some trees to chop down. Well, this is just a stick. I seem to have circled the island, so while we're here, let's get the fire going and cook some items. Yeah, let's cook some meat. And while this cooks, let's find a small tree to chop down. There we go, I think this one will do. And it gives us wood. Pun definitely not intended. Wooden mast, wooden hull. Oh yeah. And gloom harrow figurehead. I don't much care about that. And figureheads in general, depending on whatever animal we've killed. Hull armors, wooden deck. Oh, that's going to be much better than the bamboo one. But we need silk thread for that. A wooden mast that we also need silk thread and wooden hulls. Couldn't find much else in the way of supplies, so off to the next island we go. So, we already found the three key pieces we need to end this chapter, but I'm going to do a little bit more of exploring, just to pick up wood. Also, I might backtrack to, the other islands we found, So we can chop down some trees. Right, so where should we head next? Well, the previous islands are pretty close by, so yeah, let's go there. So we're back at the second island we found on this chapter. Let's get exploring for some trees. There, on top of that hill. I can see two already. Three. Four. Oh my god, we've been blessed. Oh right, it's the island with the Planeswalker. That might be a little bit problematic. But you know, we can always try and avoid that. So yeah, let's do exactly that. So I've picked up 5 pieces of wood and we're ready to leave this island and go back to actually the first island with the key shrine we found on this chapter, and then the very first island we actually found on this chapter in general. I'm going to skip ahead to those islands. So, this island over here with the first shrine we found on this chapter had absolutely nothing except for a few silk moths and whatnot. And now we're on the first island of the chapter, where I can see at least 3 trees we can chop down. So let's get to that. Also, yeah, it's the bighorn thingy again. Dead to 3 arrows. That's great. So I picked up all the wood I could find, but we're not close enough to make a full wooden boat. Right, so let's get to some cooking. And now I think it's time to explore the rest of the map, just in case we find some islands to gather some supplies and build a better boat. So we're right here, almost at the bottom of the map, and I think we're going to do the circle around, yeah, our current map, just in case we find the island, as I said before. I'm going to skip ahead to the next island I find. So let's get going. I can see something in the distance over there, which I'm guessing is somewhere around here. So let's get to that. Alright, I can see a few sticks and trees already. That's actually what we want. Let's get to chopping. Also, oh yeah, that's a health altar. Let's increase our health. That's great. Oh, there's a bunch of sticks here. There we go. All picked up except for one last tree. Alright, this seems to be just a tiny island with only a few supplies that were actually quite useful. Now it's time to move on. So I'm going to keep heading north just in case we find some islands on this side of the map, then go all the way to the top and then back around here. And already I think I can see an island off in the distance. Yeah, no? Maybe, possibly. Oh, I see a lot of stuff around here. Yeah, let's keep heading this way. There seems to be a thing shining right in the middle of the sea. Is that something I should worry about? Well, let's find out. Oh, it's gone. No, it's here. It's here. I can see it now. It's a cell of some sort. Can we dive? No, we can't dive yet. Right, what can we do about that? Can we shoot it? No, that doesn't seem to work. I might have to come back here, but it's going to be weird to remember where this is. And I see a lot of frogs on this side. Oh, and is that an island over there? Yeah, it would seem so. Let's go there. Wait a minute, I think we've already been on that island. Yeah, we have. It was the island with the strange rock formations. So, yeah, other way we go. Also, there are strange rock formations over here. Yeah, let's explore that for a bit. Oh, and there is a natural staircase here. That's good, I guess. Let's see what this is all about. I could have gone that way, but why do that? Is that some pots? Oh, and a huge jump. Can I do this, or I should probably have the glider with me. Can I make this? I can, and yeah, I have enough items, so let's do it. There we go, it's all ready. So let's try this. Nice. Can we break these rocks? No. But there's that weird humming again. Is there a shrine nearby? Is there something up there? Even if it is, we can't reach that. Right, let's do a glide around. Oh, she falls fast. Right, we're going to use the boat to check around that piece of the island. I can't really see anything on this part of this little rock. Yeah, I think we're good for now. Right, let's get moving. So we're heading to this north part of the map, and then we're going to go around the west, the east, excuse me. And look what we found just in the middle of nowhere. A little piece of land filled with bones, I think. What's going on here? Oh, there is a money altar. Yeah, let's take that. No, it wasn't the bones, just rocks. This looks like a place of rituals. And we've got 125 sea shards. Right, let's get out of here. So I've reached the causeway that we delivered the keys, but I can also see some land over there. Let's check that out first, and if there's nothing that way, well, it will be time to end the chapter. Oh shit, here is the battle music again. Are we going to see a monster this time? No, there seems to be nothing. Stop weirding me out, game. I don't know, something might be chasing us, but I also see a little piece of land over there. Let's go visit that. Yeah, we haven't visited it. It's actually a little island with just patches of grass and some clay. I have enough clay in storage. And a money altar. Yeah, that's why this exists. Let's get the money. Right, the only thing I can see from here is that weird floating rock that I'm guessing is just the game haven't loaded properly or something like that. Let's go check that out, and then it's time to end the chapter. So it turns out that that weird floating rock we saw from that island there is this little strange formation of rocks, which in game language I'm guessing it speaks secret. Yeah, there is an urn up there. Let's go check it out. Oh, there are three urns there. I'm guessing it's just money. Yeah, yeah, and yeah. Can we climb higher? No, I can't. Okay, doesn't matter. Shit, I just saw why the music is getting to battle mode at sea sometimes. It was a giant shark or something like that. There it is. I don't want to fight you. Go away, please. You are freaking fast, eh? Yeah, please leave me alone. I don't want any trouble, sir. Are we about to see some new death animation? No, 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 no. Just go on your merry way. Plenty of fish to eat in the sea. Yeah, there you go. And let's crash our boat at the beach. There we go. Now we are ready to deliver the keys. And through the magic of bad editing, it's easy as 1, 2, and 3. All right, secretures, show us some story. Well, that happened. The third crossing, Covenant. Right, so apparently the weird sea creature got angry at the humans and started destroying their towns and villages and whatnot. And they started fighting back while it started breaking their ships. And now most of them are dead. Fantastic. This gets darker and darker. The game crashed and I had to play through the whole chapter once again, but we gained an important piece of knowledge that I want to impart onto you. Save as often as you can. Save every time you reach an island. Save every time you scout the island and collect the resources and all that. Save every time you leave the island. It's just save. I don't know if this is a problem with my console, but if you're playing on Switch, just make sure you save a lot, because the game loves to crash. I don't know what's the situation with other platforms, but on Switch, yeah, we have some technical issues. Now, let's get to ending this chapter. Same deal again, go through the currents and I'm guessing first we're going to meet the weird sea creature again. Yeah, there it is. Well, that's bad. Are we going to have to fight you now? No, doesn't look like it. Right, I think this is a part where the riffs start to appear. And lots of jagged rocks. Oh, there's a boat. Okay, that was funky. Right, we're ready to go again. Had a little problem there with the reef, but now it's smooth sailing. Yeah, the ride seems to be a lot bigger this time. Straight into the rock. Also jellyfish. All right, that hurt a bit. And we made it. That's nice parking the boat there. Right, what blessings can we get now? So, significantly less stamina drain when sprinting, that sounds nice. And a bow that slows down time. No, I'm thinking to go with the less stamina drain. Yeah, that sounds a lot better. Now, the blessings I have active is the ancestral bow, that's really really good because it never breaks, and also a small increase to the number of held item slots, which is technically an upgrade of our inventory. But yeah, the less stamina drain when sprinting sounds good as well, so let's do that. Right, now our bags are full. Yeah, we're going to do something about that later. Now, let's get into the void and finish this chapter. Chapter 4, the tipping point. So, we made it to chapter 4 after some deaths, sometimes the game crashing, and fun stuff in general. And yeah, the game actually picks up the difficulty and becomes even more interesting. We also found some recipes about many things. Specifically, the one that interests me the most is Yeah, building the wooden boat, but we're going to need a lot of wood for it. So the next chapter is going to have a lot of farming and grinding, but we will do all of that next time. Until then, stay safe and have fun.